Hello, here's the Silicon Valley Free-moN Why Not module, or part of it. And we need some shotgun shacks for this company town. So I'm going to show you how to make some simple shacks out of styrene. It's always good to work off a prototype photo. This is up in the Yukon. But it keeps things real. We're going to be using some evergreen clapboard styrene. It's very easy to use. Also got some doors and windows from Titchy and Grantline. And we'll be using those to measure everything off. About 10 scale feet high. No, I think the walls are about 8 feet high. You just score and snap. I'm making 4 shacks at the same time just to knock a whole bunch of them out of the way. But using a sharp X-Acto knife, score and snap. Got the sides and the ends. To get the doors and the windows, I'm going to be using... I hate using the X-Acto knife. It's very tedious and I always seem to cut everything up. So at Michael's, a craft store, I found a hole punch which has a rectangle head. And it's about $3.50, and there's a reason for that. It's pretty cheap, so be very go easy when you squeeze, or else the whole metal bends. But it's very easy to punch some holes. It's square up, and then you just nibble away. File to get everything square and flush, and then using some double-sided tape on a paper towel, lay out all the small little pieces for painting. Using gray primer, spray both sides of everything gray primer. And then remove the gray details like the windows and whatnot, and spray the front white. Okay, then I use some random cedar shingles from Republic Locomotive Works on a styrene subroof. And they kind of curl up at the edges even with the spray adhesive, so I like to put a little extra glue on the edges. The shingles are spray painted gray and black, or grimy black, or dark gray, or whatever you want. You're going to weather them later anyway. Then using some thick CA, put the styrene side end posts that they're spray painted gray for a little contrast. Put those on the ends, and then file the tops to get the so the roof sits flush. Use a Floquil foundation to paint in some what do you call them? Blinds. You could also use pieces of manila envelope if you don't want to paint. And then putting the whole thing together. Just a little bit of CA, and then you can actually pretty much just use your hands and eyeball the right angle, but if you want a really true right angle, then you can use some Legos. Legos are 90 degrees, but they're also plastic, so watch out with the CA. You might stick the Legos to the structure. Okay, once you get the structure assembled, to block out the light, you can put a little black construction paper in the center so you can't see through it. And then if you want to raise it up, you can put some posts in the corners. This also reinforces the corners. And you can just eyeball the length, because you're going to push it down to the dirt anyway. You can use either a piece of styrene or a piece from the shingles as the cap along the ridge of the roof, so there's no crack. These are Bragdon weathering powders. You can just lightly brush them all on. You can go back with a harder brush later if you want to get some more streaks of different colors. And then I just CA it in place, because I don't want this moving around at all. So just put the CA, squish it down. Put some trees around it, and you got your simple shack. And you can put a whole bunch of other details, like a wood pile or laundry in the back or fence. And you need some people too, but we'll get to that later. So hope this was helpful. Now get scratching.